106 R&B and throwbacks on 106 Live Radio. Radio. Atlanta's music leader.
Six Live Radio, where excitement meets diversity 24/7. Man, it's your boy Ty here, man. Welcome back to another episode of Truth Be Told, man. Very happy to have y'all back, man. And just hope that everybody had a productive week, man. You know what I'm saying? Handle some business and got things done. You know what I'm saying? Accomplish some things. Man, we got a special guest in the building today. You know what I'm saying? Man, listen, he's an actor, producer, he's a writer. And actually a new Orlando urban film. Best feature film award winner. Man, you got your boy Robert Slocum in here today, man. What's going on, fam? Man, nothing much.
Appreciate it.
Absolutely, man. Glad to have you here, man. So we're gonna be with Robert Slocum today, man. He's gonna be able to, you know, talk about his time as a film producer and as a writer, you know what I'm saying? Just his life, his upbringing, man, out here in Atlanta, man. So y'all stick tuned, man. Stay with me here. Truth Be Told, 106liveradio.com. Be right back after the couple of songs, man.
Let me show you the way to go. I don't know everything, but there's something I do know.
I know.
I've read and heard a lot, and I already do show that we can come together and think like one. Come together now, live together underneath the sun. Please, let me show you the way to go. For me, my friend, oh, let me show you the way to go. Just put your trust in me. I'll try not to let you down. The job is hard to do, but all we can do is come. Cause we can help each other to overcome. We can do it, we can do it now. Just everybody. Let me show you now.
I want you.
I got to have you. Tell me how you feel.
I'll be obliged if you step outside, because my ride is awaiting. I date it, a steak it, a nightcap, we mate it, awaken. My smell's a perfume that I inhale, and then tell I will be raised hell on a diesel. Satin sheets, keep from your feet, keep me warm. The boom is perfected with the sounds from the storm. You strong, so I lasted long, and I'm everlasting. Your mouth was fantastic, the goodness that you passed it. The way you made a player laugh, I had to get you. And when I saw that jazz pass, I had to shit. You're making me fight against my will. What must I do?
Would you kill for me?
Yeah, if my life's in danger too.
Even steal for me?
Yeah, if that stuff belongs to you.
Then feel for me?
Yeah, if the way you act is true. Who knows? Fine clothes, Lexus doors, you'll be closed. And when you become one of the chosen, those in different places, different faces, different cases. Got me tied like shoelaces. No mistake. It's MJG, you ain't got to be constantly trying to shoot that B, claiming that you ain't heard of me. Keeping it real, let me know how you feel. Woman, communicate, we'll be straight. If you express your mind instead of preferring to wait, some who can't do it lose women. But MJG used to it, space age man.
New day, every once in a while, this is how it's laying
on
day.
New day, new day, and it's too strong. You and I, me and you, situation getting sticky. Your mouth is saying, but your body's saying. Be afraid of what your friends say. Rappers get that loopy, then be out of here like yesterday. But not tonight, you look so tight, it feels so right. This wasn't at me perb, let's go hop in my suburb and ride till we get to where you want to be. No matter how far, just call me ball, baby, to me, you're the superstar. Ask me time and time again, why did I choose you? Do I want to be your man or just misuse you? I hear your partners dissing when they think I ain't listening. Them leeches just be wishing they could be in your position. With me in luxury, I got to be every day. Cheap and hay with something stout, wearing lingerie. Let's hit the tail, get a suite and order something to eat. Tell me things about you and I'll tell you things about me. Then out the blue, I'll be caressing you, undressing you. You start doing all the things you said you'll never do. Lusting, busting, all out of my boxer drawers. Fingers constantly telling me the things you don't do, yet you do it like a pro and think that I don't know. But I do, that's why I'm here with you, and you know this. Slip on the latex and dive in. Swish.
Every once in a while, this is how it's slang again. Nothing is too strong not to run.
Yeah. 106 Live Radio, where excitement meets diversity 24/7, man. As I stated before, man, I got a very, very special guest in the building today. It's my boy, Robert Slocum, man. What's going on with you, bro?
Man, I'm just excited to be here, man. I'm honored to be here. The vibes is everything.
Yeah, man. Good to have you here, brother. You know what I'm saying, man? It's nice to finally meet this brother, man, because I've been hearing some wonderful things about you, bro. You know what I'm saying? Likewise,
bro.
Man, hey, look. God is good, bro. You know what I'm saying, man? One thing about it, man, tell us, man, you're from Atlanta, Georgia, correct?
Born and raised, man.
So tell us about your upbringing, man. How was that, man? How does that, you know, influence you in your art, man?
Oh, man. Where do I begin? My upbringing is everything. My family is from Joyland. I'm by way of Adamsville. So
true.
MLK all my life.
Word.
I come from a family of laborers and hustlers, man. So both of those qualities were instilled within me. My mom was nursing all my life. My biological father, hustler, you know.
Yeah.
My stepfather, I don't like to call him that because he's my father. He raised me as well. So
respect.
Just to differentiate, but he was a hustler, what we call a jack boy, turnt laborer. He went to the military, got his stuff together, and has been working for UPS forever. So with that kind of complexity of growing up, I grew up with a lot of different
visions, views, and it was a lot going on, guaranteed.
So
it just inspired that creative touch in you, you know what I'm saying? Like, you got a lot of different stories and different variations of, you know, perspectives coming out of your upbringing. So that, like, really inspired, like, your creativity and what you do.
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah. So you got a film called Slime Race, don't you?
Yes, I do.
Yeah. Does that have, like, any type of, bipartisan of, you know, how your upbringing was?
Oh, yeah. It does. Slime Race, it'll be dropping on Tubi soon.
Solid.
We're looking at the fall. But, yes, sir. The movie is about a kingpin who's murdered in prison.
Mm-hmm.
And so after his murder, the Slime Race begins. Everyone that's close to him is after his secret $10 million stash.
Of course.
So you have his estranged wife who's trying to coach their older children to find it. You have his baby mothers who hate each other. They form an alliance. They be like, we'll put our differences aside, get this money, make sure our kids straight.
Yeah.
Then you got his lieutenants who feel unappreciated.
So he's coming from all angles.
You got dirty cops.
Man.
Then you throw the cartel in there, man. You got one hell of a movie, man.
Man, that's what's happening, man. You know what I'm saying? Like, being able to have them different perspectives, you know what I'm saying? And being able to, you know, have that type of inspirational upbringing, even in the murk, you know what I'm saying? You still found some inspiration, you know what I'm saying? To be able to level up, you know what I'm saying? And then be able to get your vision out there as well. You know what I'm saying? Like, cause a lot of people, they don't understand what goes on, you know what I'm saying? So like when you're creating these films, you know what I'm saying? Cause I know you got family, bro. You know what I'm saying? Like you together, bro. You know what I'm saying? Like,
appreciate that, man.
You're like, it's all a family type dynamic as far as your business goes, isn't it correct?
Oh yes.
Yeah.
My wife is my left, my best friends who I grew up with, they my rights.
Right.
Man, people we meet along the way, like-minded individuals, like, man, shout out to my dude Mario.
Yeah, shout out
to Mike, man. Shout outs to Barbie, Dakari, man.
Yeah.
And if I don't mention your name, please forgive me. Charge it to my mind and not my heart. Y'all know I love y'all. I'm Eyes Glued Productions.
And that's what it is.
To the core. Alicia.
Word. Squad.
Squad.
Nah,
yeah.
For real, bro. You know what I'm saying? Like, and tell us about that, because you know, that's your whole brand. You know what I'm saying? Eyes Glued Productions. Like, because it's obvious, you know what I'm saying, when it comes to, you know, your films and what it is that you write, your product is going to be worthy enough for our eyes to be glued.
I appreciate
to this set. You get what I'm saying?
Hence the name.
You feel me? So like, how, like, is that where your mind was when you thought about it? Or like, was it something that just like came up? Like, how did that come about, bro?
Exactly. I was talking to a friend and I was just really trying to come up with a name. I wanted something to be catchy, but something grand.
Word.
And at first, I think I went along with something called Pinnacle Vision, or like, but a lot of stuff was taken.
Right.
And Pinnacle Vision was dope, but it just wasn't deep enough to me. And so my friend asked me, they were like, what is it that you want people to do for your films? Like, what do you want to leave them with? I'm like, I don't know. I just want their eyes glued to whatever production I have, whether it's a stage play or film or television.
Yeah.
They were like, there you go.
Ding.
I was like, shit.
Yeah.
Eyes Glued Productions.
Yeah. It came on. That, man, that's what's happening. And typically that's how it happens. You know what I'm saying? You'd be like just talking, having a casual conversation, you know what I'm saying? Or just thinking, whatever the case may be. you hear something, you'd be
mad struck.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? And that's a beautiful thing, man. Like, so how do you balance this? You know what I'm saying? Because you're out here, you know what I'm saying? You working with the lines of, you know, Dame Dash, you know what I'm saying? The great Dame Dash, you know what I'm saying? You working with the lines of, you know, who else? Big I see Faison Love, Cass. Big Boy, you know what I'm saying? That's what's happening, Cass all time. Man, tell us how you balance, you know, your work with your home life, you know what I'm saying?
Man, I don't have a specific formula. I just do. I'm fortunate to have a great partner. My wife, Jasmine, she came aboard. You know, she wasn't with Eyes Glued at first. Yeah. She was always supportive. But I think just seeing me and knowing what she had to offer.
Yeah.
And then she was like, no, he's really going to do this. And he's going to be successful. He's not going to let anything stop him.
Right.
I think it's like contagious, man. It's infectious. So she was like, man, I'm going to come and I'm going to help you. Because she brought structure.
There it is.
And so, you know, I'm a hustler, man. All I know is go get.
Right.
And I'm going to get it done. I don't always have the best methods or the easiest methods or tactics, but all I know is get it done. And it's good to have that balance with that structure.
Mm.
But as far as my family go, man, it's not where I want it to be because this is like the beginning.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, this is, we're at the takeoff time. So I am really laser focused with work, but my children are my everything.
Man.
So it's some type of way they're incorporated with me. So
absolutely.
And I learned to multitask as well. So true. Man, I'll be playing with them and typing with another hand.
There it is.
I mean, yeah. You got the videos on IG to prove it, bro. I come up with something.
But well, you gonna both do it,
has
you do
to
it.
Be done. Right?
Yeah. And it's nothing like a supportive woman, you know what I'm saying, by your side.
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying? Help you, you know, balance out what it is that you don't have. You know what I'm saying? Like that's a beautiful thing in the partnership. So, man, look, check it out. He said, man, the plane is about to board, man. He about to get up out of here. Bro, check it out. Y'all strap y'all seatbelts, man. I'm about to pay some bills real quick. And then we're going to get back and talk to Robert Slocum, man. It's a pleasure to have him here, man. You know what I'm saying? Over here honored talking about here. What it is that he got going on, man. We appreciate you, bro. So, man, y'all stay tuned real quick, man. We're going to pay some bills real quick, man. And then we'll be right back here on Truth Be Told, 106liveradio.com, where excitement meets diversity, 24/7.
Broadcasting live from Atlanta while serving the entire globe. It's the fastest growing radio on the web. It's 106liveradio.com.
This is how we do every day. We be grinding, and if you want to come and text us,
if you love them enough to turn off your music and pretend like their music is your music.
Ah, this is mommy's jam.
Then surely you'll check nhtsa.gov/the right seat to make sure they're in the right car seat.
Let's play it again.
Check today at nhtsa.gov/the right seat. Brought to you by the National Highway Traffic Safety Administration and the Ad Council.
Everton Christie and the World Financial Group at the Live Oak Financial Center are ready to assist you with all your financial goals. We move you from uncertainty and insecurity to financial freedom. Dreaming of financial independence or having dreams of starting a new career? Get your financial foundation built right with services from debt management, retirement planning, personal financial strategy, life, health, and Medicare insurance planning, and so much more. Every goal begins with the very first step. Financial independence is not just a dream, it's a decision. Call or text Everton Christie at 919-218-4962 or reach out to him at www.fgconnects.com/Everton Christie.
Here's a fun fact for you. The average chameleon can point their eyes in two different directions. On the other hand, the average human can't. So unless you're a chameleon, there's absolutely no way you can focus on texting and driving at the same time. So don't do it, unless you're a chameleon.
Visit StopTextsStopWrecks.org. A message brought to you by the National Highway Traffic Safety Administration, Project Yellow Light, and the Ad Council.
On Mondays, come hang out with our money guru as he helps you on your chase for that paper.
It's Money Mondays with Dennis Charles and his co-hosts, Nadine Ellis and Everton Christie. Invest your time with us, and in return, you'll receive financial education. Call in at 404-464-8785. Money Mondays broadcasts live every Monday from 4 to 6 p.m. Powered by 106liveradio.com.
You're never completely ready to adopt a teen.
For late nights writing English papers.
For your teen's music taste.
For dinners, where they talk more on their phone than with you.
For the first time, they call you mom.
You're never completely ready to adopt a teen, and you can't imagine the reward.
To learn more about adopting a teen, visit AdoptUSKids.org.
Brought to you by the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services, AdoptUSKids, and the Ad Council.
Let's think about it, or remember what we're thinking about. The brain is an amazing part of the human body. Brain tumor awareness is so important. Symptoms include new and increasing strong headaches, blurred vision, loss of balance, confusion, and seizure. Do not think twice to get yourself checked if you have any of these symptoms. Just a reminder from Dr. Curtis Minter.
Do you have a business that you'd like to promote? Or maybe you just want to sponsor the show and keep the good vibes going. If you would like to, the information is up on the screen. You can find us at www.106liveradio.com, or you can give us a call, 404-689-5483.
Broadcasting live from Atlanta. Like us on Facebook, follow us on Twitter, and be sure to tell everyone else,
ladies and gentlemen,
about 106liveradio.com.
With your boy Ty Lemon, man. Truth be told, we still in here with Robo Slocum, man. Bro, tell us about the Prince of Detroit, because I'm hearing things, man. Tell me about that, man, because, you know, as I stated before, this did win an award, correct?
Yours truly, myself, man, we just won at the New Jersey International Film Festival.
Man.
We were honored at the Orlando Black Film Festival, and we will be airing next Thursday, September 22nd, 8:45 p.m. at the Regal Atlantic Station Theater, The Prince of Detroit. We'll be at the Atlanta Black Film Fest.
Yeah.
ATL, so.
So you said September 22nd, right?
September 22nd.
Okay, at Atlantic Station, man. Yes, sir. What's happening, man. That's dope, man. So, like, tell us about your experience, man, because this is, you know, directed Dame Dash. This is, you know, a plethora of, you know, Columbus Short. I think I see Faison Love.
Yeah, you
do. Yeah, Big Worm. If anybody know Big Worm,
yeah.
Faison, you know what I'm saying? Like,
icons. Word.
Like, yeah, big time icons, man. Like, how does that feel coming? We talked about your story, bro. So, like, how does that feel coming from the trenches, bro, and then being in the sight of, you know, these individuals, bro.
Bro, I like to say, man, your idols become your coworkers.
Word.
So, man, and it's like, if you was to ask me maybe like 15, nah, I ain't gonna even lie like that. I can't count, man. I always knew I would be here. I would make
it. Right, right. It's just a matter of when.
Yeah. But, man, The Prince of Detroit, it's a story about a serial entrepreneur by the name of Tommy Duncan.
Mm-hmm.
The dude is a spectacular character, man. He made his fortune as a black man in the rare field of medical, HMOs,
word,
insurance.
Okay.
He sold his company for $120 million.
Based on the true story.
Correct. Grew up in Detroit. Mom, beautiful spirit, beautiful soul, very intelligent, educated woman. Attended Michigan State.
Mm-hmm.
Just came from brilliant stock, man. his family was the first family, black or white, to own a hospital and an HMO.
Word.
So, you know, I like to tell him, like, man, you're not only black history, you guys are historical figures throughout the United States, the Absolutely. Entire United States. So.
Absolutely. And he still don't do that. That's still not a thing.
Yeah, man. You know,
in its own way.
And it's such a great story, man. It's empowering. And like, it's a story of a kid that had it all growing up. Parents were making more money than Michael Jordan in the 90s. Stepfather was the manager of the group, the Dramatics.
Okay.
This is all in Motown. This
Detroit. You know, Motor City.
He grew up with some colorful characters, but had it all growing up. Went to a prestigious high school where Chris Webber and all them attended.
Mm-hmm.
But he was the only black kid there without a scholarship, an athletic scholarship at that.
Mm.
And so, because his parents could afford it. And like I say, man, he had it all. Parents lost it all. He utilized all their teachings and got it back tenfold. So it's a story of triumph. It's a story of failure and redemption.
Word.
It's like, it's the most beautiful story that has never been told until now. When I met Tommy and he sat me down and discussed this story, I'm not going to lie. All I saw was this rich guy. I was like, man, I'm sure it's going to be an interesting story, but I thought it was going to be something dorky. But man, when I tell you, this story it's beautiful, man. Just watching all the people that poured into him, from his mother, his father, his stepfather, like that blended family, how they kept the core. Family is everything.
Mm-hmm.
And even when everything was against them and they were down and out, the way they was able to resurrect, man, it's just beautiful. Wow,
yeah, that's deep. That's deep, man. And I'm pretty sure that helps inspire like a lot of your, you know, new material, you know what I'm saying, based off the things that you've learned and the people that you've bumped knuckles with. You get what I'm saying? Right. Like,
took me to a whole nother world. So absolutely right.
Right. So tell, because that's dope. That's dope in the mug, man. And people need to go check that out. You know, we got a couple of people in the comments saying that they can't wait to check it out. You know what I'm saying? And Slime as well. You know what I'm saying? They can't wait to check these things out. You know what I'm saying? So, like, that's all respect, man. We have a lot of kids that watch this show, right? So tell me something, like, tell the kids something, like, how... We all get into ruts, right, when we're writing.
Right.
Okay? So, from your perspective, from Robert Slocum's perspective, like, what is it that you do whenever you get in a position where you're not inspired, to where you're not feeling creative? Do you, are there times when you still push the envelope, you know what I'm saying, and just keep on doing it, or do you allow, like, time to inspire, you know, your next work, or...
It depends on the project. What's my time frame?
Mm-hmm.
There are times where I'll just muscle through it.
Yeah.
And somehow, some way, I don't be as pleased with it because I feel like it was forced and it wasn't as good as it could have been, but I know I had to muscle through it.
Right.
There are times where I just feel like I have to take a mental break. But for the most part, if I get like writer's block or I'm stuck,
mm-hmm.
I have so many projects. I have a plethora of them, man. Mm-hmm. So when I'm writing, I just move to another project and come back.
Because
if I'm not feeling this one, it's 9 times out of 10. I can only speak for myself. Mm-hmm. I'm not going to have block for every single project I have. I'm like, it's time for me to focus more on this one. Right. And so that inspiration and motivation come back for this one.
Right.
So
it helps to get that balance together.
Right,
because
I'm a workaholic, man. I love it. So it's kind of hard for me to get writer's block, but it does occur from time to time.
Yeah, yeah. But, you know, when you have, like, you know, projects set aside and you've already been working, you know what I'm saying, it's not too hard to tap into, you know, what it is that inspires you at that particular moment. You know what I'm saying? You can be inspired by, you know, just being.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? And something could come up from that and you just like, man, dang.
Man, bro, I have movie ideas based off casual conversation, man.
Dang.
I could be riding around in the car just staring out the window I get a movie idea from
right.
It's crazy. One phrase, one term, you'll be surprised, man. Yeah. So,
So that's really a testament right there. You know what I'm saying? Definitely for the shorties. And then also for, you know, adults who still get, you know what I'm saying, like, just don't have no type of creativity. The writer's block is there, you know what I'm saying, so on and so forth. Even without writer's block, just in life in general, you know what I'm saying? So your testament is good for everybody out there because, you know, everybody deals with things in different ways, you know what I'm saying?
Exactly.
We all the same, but we all so different. You know what I mean? So it's like, that's a beautiful thing, you know what I'm saying? That's good to be inspired by. Like, that's good, bro. So, like, tell me, within your film process, like, what is the main takeaways that you get from working in different sets, man? You know what I'm saying? Like, because this slime, I see that you got, like, mixtape coming, you know what I'm saying? Like, all types of stuff.
Yeah, we dropped like, mixtape.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? Like, that's different, bro. You get what I'm saying? Like, that doesn't always happen, you know what I mean? So, like, you're obviously learning something. You have your own creativity there, but then there's also things that you take from, you know, other sets and, you know, from other people, like, you know, inspiration wise. Like how are you inspired, like, to, like, get to a point where you're putting out mixtapes with, you know, with your films, bro? Like, tell me something.
I'm inspired by others because, like, man, I really want to see everybody win.
Yeah,
that deserves it. So I'm seeing these artists putting out this dope ass music. I'm seeing people with these dope designs and clothing lines.
Right.
I'm like, man, put it in my movie.
There you go.
I'm not gonna charge you. I'm like, man, we can make a whole mixtape. I want everybody to win. I'm not just doing this. I realized a long time ago, and that's what made Eyes Glued Productions great in my heart.
Right.
It's bigger than me.
Right. Mm-hmm. So being able to infuse others in there, you know what I'm saying? And it's really just cross promotion.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Just putting on with cross promotion, bro.
And it's rare for you to hear me say my or, you know, I and all this. Like, when we're doing a project, it's my team.
Right.
So it's our project because I can't get it done without them.
Yeah.
You know, everybody was like, well, you wrote it. Yeah, but it takes more than that to get it on that screen. Believe
Absolutely. So, like, others have to be interested. My fault. I ain't mean to
cut you off. No, you're good, bro. It's just like the struggle makes you appreciate those who support you and those who are fighting for you even more. Mm-hmm. And so, like, yeah, I would love for Robert Slocum to be in a great place. But I'm not going to be in that great place by myself. I got to bring minds with me.
Wow.
And that's what motivates me. That drives me more than anything. It's a team sport.
Absolutely.
And I'm like, I look at the LeBron, how, you know, he did his thing. And now his group of friends and his family, they're a conglomerate.
Right.
So why can't I do that?
I love that, bro. That's a beautiful perspective, man. And I saw it, and I'm like, man, that's different. Like, when does the mixtape drop?
No, it already dropped.
It already dropped?
It's on livemixtapes.com.
Okay, I'm going to check it out, because I rock with live mixtape. Like, boy,
it's fire, bro. I'm not just saying it. No, like, we had so many submissions, and I'm like, man, I wish I could have put everybody's song on there. But, you know, we had well over 100 submissions.
Right.
And so we chose, like, the best 22.
Okay.
Tracks, yeah. I believe. And mixtape is named after the movie Slime Race. So.
That's what's happening, like, man. So you wanna say any of the names that's on there?
Yeah, man. We got Blessed. We had a song Slide, my man Mark.
Okay.
Dude blessed us with that one, man. That's like the most popular song on there. Man, we had a dope artist by the name of Von Shway. Had a kid from Jersey, dude, like 18, produced his own tracks, Money Monster.
Yeah.
Man, he got like an island vibe to it. So, like, you know, I got a couple of them, like Sean Kingston vibes, like on there.
Word.
Dude is a beast. He's a kid, the most humble, loyal, most modest, talented kid. I was like, dude, if I had a label, I would sign you right now. I was looking at it from like the mixtape. Got local legends like Cachet.
Word.
Man, she did her thing. She's on there. Yeah. Oh, man. I can go on and on, man. This is like, that's dope, the mixtape is fire, bro.
That's raw, though. That's raw, man. That's a dope idea, man. And just a excellent way to, you know, keep creative, bro. You know what I'm saying? And keep on, you know, busting through the walls, bro. When it comes to like it's levels, so much,
bro. I'm sorry.
No, nah, you good. We talking, bro.
It's so much easier. So much even better. It's more gratifying, bro. When you can do stuff as a collective. Mm-hmm. When you come together, you're so much more powerful. And I think when our people finally realize that for real, instead of all this competing, there's no stopping us.
I feel that. So, I mean, even with that, man, because you just seen the, you know, the assassination of PNB, you know what I'm saying? Like, you know, situations like that. Like, how do you feel about, you know, situations that come across in that manner? You know what I'm saying? Like, you know, on either side, bro.
I have a lot of mixed emotions, man, because, you know, I came up, you know, I'm from the west side of Atlanta, so there's not much I haven't seen, experienced, so, you know. Right. So, I understand when people say, bro, don't be putting your business out there. You know, you have to learn to move that way, but I also feel the shame that you have to move that way. Like, why couldn't his woman post their meal?
Right. Just trying to live.
Right.
Yeah.
Just she's enjoying herself. If that's how she enjoys herself, why she couldn't post her picture?
Right.
And stay where she's at, having fun, promoting the restaurant, the establishment.
Right.
You know, you have to worry about somebody killing your loved one. It's, man, it's crazy, man. Yeah. So, like, it's so much of this going on now. Like, we started a movement, Eyes Glued Production. It's called Shoot Films, Not People. It's okay. Our initiative.
That's what's happening.
So, yeah, man, we avidly working with the government. The mayor stamped us. Marvin Arrington, man. Okay. Michael Bunn.
Like, okay, yeah.
Like, we got all the commissioners, right. The city councilmen, man. Like, they really took us under our wing. Khadijah, man. So, what we're doing is, we're starting off in my neighborhood where I grew up. That's Exit 9, Martin Luther King. We're going to go to the neighborhoods, recruit all those active youths, all the active people that's out there committing these crimes, and we're going to get them jobs in the entertainment field. Solid. What do you want to do in filming? Do you want to help with the camera work? Do you, you know, you want to be part of the filming crew? Do you want to act?
Right.
Do you want to write?
Right.
I need writers. I need help. I can't. I'm getting
a little foggy.
Right. Doing all this writing. And so we're going to train them, give them jobs, pay them. I've already started writing a show.
Beautiful.
Entitled Exit 9.
Yeah, because G said Exit 9 coming soon.
Exit 9, that's the truth. Exit 9
coming soon,
It's never been done. Not as far as I know. Correct me if I'm wrong. And I challenge anybody to do that.
Fact.
But we're going to have this show with our actors and kids from the real neighborhood, people from the real neighborhood.
Dope.
And we're also going to do a docuseries of us, the making of the show.
Right.
And so it's a scripted series. I'm going to have these guys acting. I'm going to get them to put down their real guns and pick up my prop guns.
There you go.
And
yeah, that's serious, bro. Because what you doing, you bringing back. You know what I'm saying? And you're actually bringing back and investing and giving a different, you know.
I want to show them a better
way, bro. It's a different way, bro. You know what I'm saying? Because there's a lot of people that, you know, they want to say, you know what I'm saying, you should do this, you should do that, but there's no solutions.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So, like, where the solution lies is where the solution lies. You know what I'm saying? Like, that's how we actually get things done.
And who doesn't want to be a star? You know, people, you know, I had people question me. They're like, yeah, you want to stop violence by promoting it on a TV show? Yeah, if I transform this kid from shooting an actual person with a real gun to shooting somebody with a prop gun and just tell their stories, because full of stories, these kids are so intelligent, they're so creative, and you know, they watch their parents struggle with 9-to-5s and, you know, barely making it and having to resort to other things. That's why they're committing the crimes in the first place, because all of this poverty. Mm-hmm. So let's show them a better way. Let's empower them. My goal is to do 2 to 3 seasons with these kids, then we just pass the show to them and right. they take it from there. And then we on to the next, because this is not going to be a local thing. We're going worldwide with this.
That's beautiful.
We're going to do a Shoot Films, Not People campaign in Detroit. Take it down to Miami, word. Indiana. Yeah. We're going to go worldwide with this global. Then we're going to catch us in Europe somewhere, England.
Right. That's beautiful, man. That's beautiful, man. You know what I'm saying? Y'all really, you know, giving it back to the, you know, the man, that's just beautiful, bro. You know what I'm saying? And man, just keep on doing that. You know what I'm saying? 96 Atlanta. What's going baby. On with that, bro? Like, I don't know if anybody heard about 96 Atlanta.
That's or not. Love yeah. Hey, there,
tell us about 96 Atlanta, bro. Like, this is the one.
Yeah. I think Exit 9 is starting to get up there, but like the team, everybody is in love with 96, man. 96 is based on true stories as well. But you know, we have fiction. It's cross mix. It's just telling the story of the rise of Atlanta. You know, Atlanta took off in 96 after the Olympics, and, you know, Freaknik was in its prime. You have the AUC. So the story is going to start in 1990. And we're just going to tell all the players that made Atlanta what it is today, because everybody know Atlanta is the it spot. Mm-hmm. But nobody knows, even people that live here, they don't know how it got that way. And all the major players from all walks of life, you know, we're going to tell the story from the lens of the politicians, from law enforcement, from the street cats. Like, there was a whole police force built to take the drug dealers down. The Red Dogs. We're going to tell that story.
Man,
in the mid to the late 80s, you had cats from Miami come up, migrate up here, try to take over Atlanta, and they were almost successful.
Man.
We're going to tell that story. The timeline might be a little bit off because we have to, you know, stick with the 96 theme, but we're going to tell these stories, and the stories are going to be pretty accurate. So,
man, that's happening. So, is it like a TV series, or is it how you have it set up?
Television series, yes. Executive produced by myself and the iconic legend, Big Boy from Outkast. Mm-hmm. Man, we're working avidly. The show is in the hands of a lot of people. So,
that's dope, bro.
We're looking
that's
to wrong. Hear back to see who wants to pick it up. If no one picks it up, Big has already said that we're going to shoot it ourselves.
That's raw.
Man, it's...
Shout out to Brother Patton as well.
Yes, man. That's my OG. That's my
solidified
dog, man.
For and real.
That's one man. If he tells you he's going to do something, he's going to do it.
Real talk. Real talk. That's beautiful, man. Well, hey, man, we about to get into a break real quick, man. We sitting here with the big homie, Robert Slocum, man.
What it do?
Man, out here, bro. We appreciate
Jordan,
this,
stand
brother.
Up.
Yeah, there it is, man. Hey, we're going to pay Bill. These bills. Hey, it's for Adam Bill. Be right back.
Broadcasting live from Atlanta while serving the entire globe. It's the fastest growing radio on the web. It's 106liveradio.com.
Come invest your time with money guru Dennis Charles. Tune in every Monday from 4 to 6 p.m. right here on 106 Live Radio.
So what's happening in politics this week? The Progressive Weekly with Charlie Levinson knows all about it. Tune in every Friday from 3 to 4 p.m. on 106liveradio.com.
Morning Rise with the Variable Y, where we keep you engaged all week with Mental Health Mondays, where we go over your mental health and we break the stigmas associated with it. Teach Me Tuesdays, where we bring in a professional to give you educational tips and strategies for success. Walk It Out Wednesdays, where we give you relationship advice to help you walk through your journey with your partner. Take Charge Thursdays, where we check in with community leaders and activists. And Freedom Fridays, where we focus on sports, entertainment, and all the happenings local and international. Check us out every morning from 6 to 10 a.m.
Ben, get inspired from 10 until 2, from 10 until 2 p.m. Monday through Friday. It's the Tinashe Gray Radio Show. It's faith-based, inspiration, education, and empowerment in the middle of your day.
It's your girl, Queen.
It's your girl, Nene.
And if you want to hear a song play right here on the Bridge Club Crew playlist every first Thursday of each month,
all you have to do is submit your music to the Bridge Club Crew at gmail.com. Powered by 106liveradio.com.
Broadcasting from Atlanta to a global audience. Are you ready to speak truth? Truth be told, providing clarity, insight, and healing. The goal is to create an atmosphere where we not only discuss the many struggles we face daily in our communities, individually and collectively. This is a platform that's meant to build each other up. Here, we learn and grow together. And I'm your host, Ty Lambert, a student of life, development, and beyond. Originally from Indianapolis, Indiana, by way of Phoenix, Arizona, and Los Angeles, California, now residing in Atlanta, Georgia. Let us work together to create solutions. Tune in to Truth Be Told every Thursday, 8 through 9 p.m., powered by 106liveradio.com, where excitement meets diversity 24/7.
We're in Atlanta, hitting the gas and turning all the way up on 106liveradio.com. Today's R&B and throwbacks.
Do you have a business that you'd like to promote? Or maybe you just want to sponsor the show and keep the good vibes going. If you would like to, the information is up on the screen. You can find us at www.106liveradio.com, or you can give us a call, 404-689-5483.
Download the 106 Live Radio app from your Google Play Store. Or find us on the TuneIn app.
TuneIn app. 106liveradio.com, where excitement meets diversity 24/7, man. It's your boy Ty Lambert here. Truth be told, man. Sitting here with the homie Robert Slocum, man. As I said before, man, it's been good to have him in the building. You know what I'm saying? Bro, I've learned a lot about you. You know what I'm saying? Like, we haven't met previously, you know what I'm saying? But we're intertwined in the same folk. Right. You know what I'm saying? So that's it. That's a testament right there. You feel
yes,
me?
Sir. I get that vibe. Like, we've been knowing each other for a minute.
Hey, man. Yeah, we was out there chopping it up, man. And I'm sitting here like, man, this dude, yeah, you know, he's 51-52. So we cool.
Shout out to Corey.
Hey, we out here, bro. Hey,
one
man.
One of my favorite comedians.
Before we get out of here, bro. You got to tell me, because you from the A, bro. How you feel about this Rotimi situation, my brother? You got you feel a way about that? Or like, is it like, man, whatever, bro?
Man, I'm going to let the man live, man. I'm a fan of Rotimi, bro. Hey, things happen, bro. That's all I got to say.
Hey, he was on that thing.
Hey, things happen.
Oh, man, bro. I've spoken with a few AT aliens, man, the past day, and they not too happy about that.
I'm Atlanta to the core, man.
I feel you. Know. But I'm going to say this, bro. It wasn't going to change the outcome. I ain't going to lie, brother.
Hey. It is what it is, man. We know it. Entertainment holding Atlanta down for now.
There we go.
The sports will catch up. That's all I'm going to say. The sports catch up. Then, you know, you got us die hard, people working hard. You know, we working. So we'll be able to afford to buy these teams and bring in prosperity. You know what I'm saying?
Real talk.
That's all I'm going to say about it. But I love all my Braves, my Falcons, my Hawks, man. We up through the.
Y'all got that title, though. My dream, too. The Braves, boy.
Oh, yeah.
Man, y'all came through one time for the one time.
Braves, you know, I always count on the Braves to hold us down every 30 years. Yeah.
They doing pretty well this season, too, though.
Oh, yeah. They looking good.
They going to repeat?
Yeah, man. You got to claim it, man.
Yeah.
Put that out there. Yeah, we're going to repeat.
I mean, they the champions, so you can't rule the champs out.
Yeah. You know what I'm saying? You got to beat the man to be the man. So, Factuals. You can actually say that right now.
I feel that. I ain't mad at it at all, man. So, hey, man, this is the homie Robert Slocum here, man. Go ahead. We know you got a festival coming up on the 22nd of this month of September, man. Go ahead and let the people know what's going on with you. You know what I'm saying? What they can look forward to, where they can find your, you know, your mixtapes and your films and so on and so forth, brother.
Okay. On Instagram, look me up at iceglued_emperor. Oh, man, we have Slime Race dropping on Tubi. Coming soon this fall, we had the Prince of Detroit. That's Atlanta, right. Come out, man. Show me love, man. I love y'all. Love me back, please. We got to show out. I got Dame Dash in the building, Tommy Duncan in the building,
man,
and a host of other special invited guests. And I mean, when I say special invited guests, you know, there's no cap in my rap.
Oh, so, man, we got to figure that out. Man. So, that's what's happening.
I'm in the process of raising funds for a project that we want to start filming at the end of the next month, in October. So things are looking promising. We got some nice people committing to it. So I'm definitely looking forward to that. I discussed that more with Mario in a minute. Man, it's beautiful, man.
That's solid.
We go back out to L.A. to finish filming because it looks like The Prince of Detroit is going to be a limited series. So we're going to do some more filming on it because we're going to, you know, it's a lot to tell someone's life story.
Absolutely.
From childhood.
Absolutely.
All the way up to adulthood until his 40s. So.
Y'all doing a good thing by doing that.
Working, man. 96 still, man. We looking for a home for 96. I can't let it out, but
don't do that.
It was some good news. So we just hoping this great news after they review everything.
That's love, man. So Exit 9 as well. Where can the people, you know, go for that?
We're gonna start filming Exit 9 early next year.
Okay.
The government, like I said, they've been genuine, man. They've been very kind. Commissioner Marvin Arrington and Councilman Michael Bunn, man, they are my mentors, and they, even before all of this film and stuff, they've been in my life, and former Mayor Cassine Reed, so they all just put a battery in my back, and like the government's gonna help fund it, so we just gotta wait till those funds replenish.
That's a beautiful thing, man. That's a beautiful thing. I heard it from him, from the source. You know what I'm saying? Straight from the source, man. That's the homie Robert Slocum. You can check out everything that he has going on. If you want to play the episode back, you can check it out. Or if you just want to check it out right now, man, go ahead and tap in, man. You know, he's doing some beautiful things out here, you know, in the film industry and also in the community, you know what I'm saying? So,
thank you, bro.
You know, hey, man, it's just a pleasure having you on, bro. You know what I'm saying? As we end this show, man, just make sure that everybody's, you know, taking care of what needs to be taken care of, man. You know what I'm saying? As the homie said, man, if you have any type of writer's block or anything blocking your, you know, your ideas or whatever the case may be, man, hey, work on something else, man. Put that inspiration behind something else. You feel me? Yeah, absolutely, man. Get a balance, you know what I'm saying? And then coagulate that thing. You feel me? So, hey, man, I appreciate everybody for tapping in. Everybody in the comments, man. Shout out to Mario Huey G up in this thing. You get what I'm saying? Shout out to Super Healer up in this thing. You get what I'm saying? So, hey, man.
You mind if I leave y'all with two quotes?
Please do.
I just want to say for all those going into the entertainment field or whatever field, prepare to hear a million no's. But know that one yes can change your life. So keep going.
Man.
And another thing, because this is a misconception that's been embedded in us. There are no plan Bs. Those are for unwanted pregnancies. So your only plan B should be another way to make plan A work. So just stay on. Keep at it, man.
That's a bar. That's a bar, man. Hey, man, take that to heart. For real. And with no further ado, man, we'll close out with that, man, because that was just that was everything, brother. So, I, like I said, man, I appreciate you coming through, Rob, man. Real talk. And, you know, y'all tap in with what it is that he has going on. Once again, 106liveradio.com, where excitement meets diversity 24/7. It's your boy Ty Lambert, man, here, truth be told, man. Y'all check it out again next Thursday, 8 through 9 p.m. Be back here again, man. Y'all take it easy. Peace.
Peace.
In the days I used to dream of being rich, having a lot of houses and cars, couldn't know which one was which, and finding me a chicken getting hitched, living a fairy tale life, perfect without a glitch. You think that this would bring me happiness? If at the end of every rainbow there was a treasure chest, sometimes having more is really less. So take a look inside yourself, you realize you're really blessed. No matter how you're sad and blue, there's always someone who has it worse than you. Sometimes you gotta pay your dues, so don't worry, just push on through.
Keeping it real.
Gotta dig up all my peoples who be working on the future, though they know they gotta struggle.
Keeping it real.
To all my peoples working on the 9 to 5 and doing right to keep themselves up out of trouble.
Keeping it real.
Although sometimes I know it seems impossible, there ain't no need in drowning in your sorrow.
Keeping it real.
If things are as bad as they can be, you could be sure there'll be a brighter tomorrow.
That's right, Simon. Yeah. Give thanks for having us.